for me, just win for me. Don't kill for me, just live for me. Keep it real for me, we eat together, leave the bill for me like.
Hand on my heart, I give it all I got. Walk the walk and talk the talk. Take it higher, that's a God. No, I give it all I got. What a walk, talk the talk. Take it higher, that's a God. Never stopping, that's a must. Always winning, never lost. GPS, I never lost. GPS, I never lost.
Who do it better than me, yeah? Vision on 2020, yeah. VVS, Club ID, yeah. Determination, laser focus. Banging on they, on they. Though they taking notice. Taking notice, taking
matching hundreds. It's a coach, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see teams with a couple of running backs who each went over 100 yards a weekend ago, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the New York Giants. I'll join you again at halftime to look at some of these stats and scores from earlier this afternoon. But for now, it's Sunday Night Football. And on the call, as always, Brandon Gott and Charles Davis.
And thank you, Coach. We are across the Hudson from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Dallas Cowboys and the New York Giants. Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you take a look at this Giants ball club. They come in feeling good after back-to-back victories.
And they had it easy last week. They jumped out to an early lead and then put it on cruise control from there.
Meanwhile, for the visitors here, the Cowboys, they're off to a terrific start, unbeaten at 5-0 through the first month and change.
And you can hang a lot of this early success on their defense, too. They're the tone setters for these guys, and the entire team feeds off of what they do.
Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. This is taken at his 4. Then he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So here are the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. It's the Mississippi State product at quarterback calling the shots will be Dak Prescott. First play, and it's second down. And on this offensive unit, your thoughts on Travis Frederick?
He's a quarterback's best friend, sets all the line calls, and blocks so aggressively.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Throwing, Prescott. And he's got the hookup here. It's Kyle Rudolph. And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. Able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive. Couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb, because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
So after a good run by Zeke, another 1st and 10. And they give this time to the tailback. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47. A look now at the starters for the Giants defensively. They were fantastic a week ago in the win over Houston.
If I'm playing quarterback against this team, after what I saw on film where they had five picks last week, all I'm thinking about is taking care of the football, being very careful with it, and making sure I see my guys open before I throw it.
I might curl up in the fetal position.
That's not a bad idea.
I don't think he's going to do that.
On second down, Elliott. And he's going to get this past the 50 and into Giant territory. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now. And an alley to run. Oh, Prescott stripped.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. The first carry now for Tony Pollard. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who could do more than one thing, and I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. 8th play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. Going to throw deep for the end zone. That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown. Amari Cooper with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Cowboys take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive.
One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Gold with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. That time, a 9-play drive, and it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. So now here are the Giants as they'll get their first opportunity here. And leading them, Charles, their quarterback, their field general.
And this could be a whole lot of fun because if his game plan goes into effect early, we're going to see some shots downfield, aren't we? What did he talk to us about? Stretching the field. Wants to open things up for not just his receivers, but for anything underneath.
Well, that was the theme, the front page of the sports section. What did the columnists write? Possible air raid. So we'll see.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how the coaches view that, right? Who gave what game plan? I think it's pretty obvious that that'll help them win.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. He'll get 15 and a Giants first down.
Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 10 yards, good for a Giant first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On the ground, this is Saquon Barkley. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 10 yards, good for a Giant first down. Another good run there for a guy who, remember, on Wednesday was named NFC Offensive Player of the Week for what he did a week ago.
Yeah, and you know it takes some solid runs and some extra special ones in order to win that type of an award. I think he's locked in and wants to get it done a second time.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Back to throw here. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. A gain of 6 there on first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Now Saquon Barkley, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Well, they need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. They'll drop the throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
And that's their first sack of this game, but how about last week? 6 sacks, great coverage downfield, which helped that pass rush. They are really working in sync right now.
Fourth down, so on is the punter, Riley Dixon. He was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Amari Cooper and the rest of the offense heading back out there now. He's well on his way to a 1,000-yard season, maybe on pace to just tear past that, Charles. Defensively, they need to pay a little bit more attention to him?
Yeah, I think so, because remember, throwing the football, that can shred a defense quicker than anything else, because as soon as the catch is made, he still has the ability to, you know, yards after catch, get downfield, gain even more, score touchdowns, all of that. This is going to be a lot of fun to watch as this progresses, to see how they defend him and how he changes up his game in order to try and keep getting open.
11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit, because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window, he fired a bullet in there for the completion. Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Cooper was the target there. That'll bring up second down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up, second and 10. Prescott to throw it. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. O'Shane Ziminis came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
2 sacks last week, another one right here. He's been unblockable lately, and I think that goes all the way back to not just his offseason, but the film study he's been doing during the week, because I think he's found matchups that he likes, and he's capitalizing.
And a few times he's even defeated double teams. He doesn't care at this point.
Need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Prescott from the gun. Oh, Prescott stripped.
Set. Got him. Let's go, boys. Let's go.
And a little bit of
of good fortune there. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. And here comes the Giants offense back out onto the field and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2. And it brings up second down. On that last run, he's now hit the 6,000-yard mark for rushing yards in his career.
And moves him squarely into the top 100 rushers of all time. In fact, he can boast that he's rushed for over 1,000 yards more than Gale Sayers did in his career. And Gale Sayers was a Hall of Famer in a short career.
From the 22, here's 2nd and 8. They'll run with Barkley. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Here's the offense, and we give you too much power here. We let you highlight the player. Why'd you choose Zeitler?
Because I think the big guys up front never get enough credit. Kevin Zeitler, a guard, tough, nasty. We've got to give him some love.
And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Now back to throw. That's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. And that's not nearly going to be enough. Stopped at the 22, and he needed plenty more. Only a yard on the third down throw, and that leads to a fourth down.
Well, the good thing about covering any game I do with you is I know that there's no problem with rhythm. Now, what we're watching offensively, a little bit of a problem there.
Yeah, punt on the first drive, looking at another one here. Just a little slow. And, you know, they were talking about a fast start, but that hasn't been the case.
Yeah, and let's face it. Any team we cover always talks about a
That's
fast
true.
Start.
That's true.
But it's not necessarily going to happen just because they say so. And whether it's the script, whether it's, you know, just what they're going through, whether they're seeing different defenses, they're going to have to figure it out as this game moves on.
And let's gaze our attention on Ezekiel Elliott. And we checked the rushing numbers so far here into week 6, and the returns have been really good. Now, you're starting to hit that stride middle of the season toward the end. They're certainly hoping they can keep up this production.
They are, because one of the adages in the NFL is that defense travels and defense endures even in bad weather, right? You know what else does? A good running game. And people want that, especially as you head down the stretch. You may play outdoors in some nasty stuff. You're trying to get to the playoffs. This is the time to get it going. And individually, I don't think you should just think about 1,000 yards either. The bar has to be set higher with this beginning.
From the 30 on second down, Prescott looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target, and it's third down. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Here's Prescott. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 17 yards on the play there, and the Cowboys have a first down.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
First down carry by Elliott. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
On first down, it's Elliott. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they were hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Play action now. Prescott. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 14 yards, good for a Cowboy first down. He's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Second and 5 now. Prescott. He was trying to get it to Ezekiel Elliott. And it's 3rd and 5. They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And the giant rush gets home as down he goes. Khalil Mack in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year.
He's the NFL sack leader coming into the game, and now that's 2 more that he's added to his total.
He wants some separation from spot 1 and 2 in that sack category. Robbie Gould on now to try the field goal. And the 39-year-old veteran puts it right through, and the lead moves to 10-0. A dozen plays on that drive that ends with the field goal.
Let's go ahead and break out some of the old chestnuts here, right, partner? Keep the ball in front, rally to it, and make the tackle, right? No big plays given up, no balls over your head. Bend, don't break.
Hold on. Chestnuts?
You like
that
one?
Come on, what does that mean, break out there? Just because you break chestnuts?
I'm not sure about that, but I'm just going with why they said that. I have no idea.
The New York set to take the field. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all, and let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Now it's Barkley. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Time for a look at our starters here on defense. Right now they're ranked number 29 in the NFL against the pass, so 4th from the bottom, Charles.
And when you're getting ready to face the number 1 overall offense in the NFL, it does not matter where you rank defensively because you got your hands full. You don't know what you're going to face, but you know that that's a strong unit that you're getting ready for.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. 2nd and 10. He's got his man on the crossing route. And now off to the races, down the right side. And all the way in, touchdown, New York. A big play there with his 16th touchdown of the year as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter.
Extra point forthcoming. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. That drive started on their own 25. Two plays, 75 yards later, into the end zone. Now after the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So here are the Cowboys to take over. Remember, they're riding that 5-game winning streak and right now in the driver's seat in this ball game as well. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at their own 27. They start on the ground with Elliott, and he'll just plow right into a host of tacklers. Nothing there at all, and it'll be 2nd and 10.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball. Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Let's go.
Give him 10 there, good enough for a Cowboy first down. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. 10-7 our score after one right here on EA Sports. They'll run on 1st down. It's Elliott. Give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down. A very solid gain on that play.
On 2nd down, it's Elliott. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The tally there, -2 yards, brings up 3rd down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
The Cowboys on 3rd down. They've been excellent, 6 for 7. This is 3rd and 7. Looking to throw, Prescott. And he's got Ezekiel Elliott. And they're going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 38-yard line.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, 1st and 10 at the 38. To throw is Prescott. And his throw is incomplete. Michael Gallup, that's who he was looking for. And that'll bring up 2nd down. They work again from the 38 on 2nd and 10. Now Prescott. Quick hitter here, it's complete. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a 3rd down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
The Cowboys on third down. They've been outstanding. 7 first downs and 8 tries. This will be 3rd and 6. Prescott down. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. Khalil Mack, what a season he continues to have. His 15th sack of the campaign. Well, for last week's performance, which was so good, he was named NFC Defensive Player of the Week. He got a lot of praise, and understandably so, from national media. Looking pretty good on that play, too.
And I love what he told us this week before the game. He talked about how much time they spend working on pass rush moves every position, because anyone could go after the quarterback in their defense, and you can see how they've all absorbed their lessons.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but they're losing. And I think as the captain of the offense, you probably always feel like you need to do more in that situation.
The best have always felt that way, and they won't settle for anything less. So right now, his goal is to increase what he's doing on the field, try to make sure his teammates come along with him, and he feels like if I do better, everyone will do better. And that's what we're seeing from him right now. Got to have a little extra determination.
Yeah, a little extra determination. He has thrown the touchdown pass, no interceptions for him personally to this point. And he's over 100 yards now after that last catch. Already, of course, leading the NFL in receiving yardage.
So he's done nothing at all to hurt his cause, to stay in that spot. But I've been so impressed with how he's gotten it done. Body control, route running. How about the way he competes for the football at the end of the play?
The big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already. On play action, they'll throw. He's going to fire one deep over. It's caught inside the 25. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 33 yards that time. But one thing's for sure, they're going to have to come up with something at halftime because he is absolutely roasting them right now.
They're going to go through the whole litany of things, changing coverages, you know, what are we going to do, put a man on him. The big thing to me is treat it like a good pitcher treats pitching a game. Change your timing, change your location. So sometimes you're up on him, sometimes you're back. Just change up the looks that he sees and make him just a little bit more hesitant.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
On second down, here's Barkley. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley, his 21st touchdown of the season. And the Giants have taken the lead.
In as many coaches' meetings as we sit in, we hear the word finish all the time, don't we? And on that play, the back actually finished getting into the end zone, breaking the last tackle. Tried to wrap up, tried to use the proper technique, just wasn't able to get it done.
Now the try here for the extra point. And that makes it 14-10. A drive there of just 4 plays. And the rookie Saquon Barkley, the one who finishes things off with a touchdown run. To the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone.
Let's go!
Zeke and the Cowboys ready to begin their next drive. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game,
because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here. Only a yard on the pickup, and now they've got a third down at 8. The Cowboys on third down. Can't fault these numbers. 7 for 9 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Fielded just inside the 30. A good return there, 17 yards. And it'll be Giant football, 1st and 10. Saquon Barkley and the Giants offense set to kick off their next drive. And he's closing in on that number that all running backs circled beginning of the year, the number 1,000. Could do it on this drive.
And you have to think to yourself that this moment, getting to this spot, it started in the offseason, right? Not just the workouts, right? Not just getting yourself physically prepared to play, but mentally, as well as your team, as well as your unit, head coach, offensive coordinator. We run the football. They give you opportunities. He's taking advantage of it.
And when you get this close to the mark, you just hope things don't tighten up, right? You probably want to get there and get it in your rearview mirror.
You really do, don't you? Because now it becomes predominant, and you wonder about play calling as well. Do you want to call plays to get that out of the way, or are you still calling plays to win the game first? That becomes the burden of the play caller.
They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he's got the first, but we also have a flag on the field. And they're already walking backwards. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
I'm going to come back to you.
They'll set up a throw. And he's got his man on the out route.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. There just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
Here's Riley Dixon now as he's on to punt for New York. The Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. The first down run for Elliott will net him about 5 yards. It's 2nd down. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5. From the 25 on 2nd down, Prescott got his man there, complete to Gallup. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
Prescott now, 11 to 15 through the air. Here's 1st and 10. Another carry tonight for the workhorse, Elliott. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be 2nd and 12.
They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result. Because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter. You're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him. Sat there waiting for him and made the play.
Right there, 54 miles. Squeeze, double.
On second and 12, Prescott drops it underneath to Elliott. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss. Out now comes the Cowboys punter. He's been terrific so far. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. So now the Giants set to take over on offense. They've won two straight, and they lead this one as well as they come up on first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. He'll look to throw. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Third and one, who are you going to call? Not the scat back. You go with the big man, hand him the ball, and let him get upfield and pick up a first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll set up to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. A give to Barkley out of the gun. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. A good pickup there, 21 yards. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary. Figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
Come on. The to throw now on first down. He'll get this out to Barkley, complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 and a Giant first down. And he is the NFC reigning offensive player of the week. You got to think, all the guys that take the field each and every week, that's not an easy award. Always has to feel good to grab it.
It has to feel great because it separates you, at least for a week, amongst your peers. And for him to separate again, he has to have the same type of a game. That means being explosive off the line of scrimmage and catching everything that comes his way.
And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2.
Let's go, D, tighten up.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. It's an 8 yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
And Barkley will try to punch it in. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
So second and goal, and standing by himself in the backfield, Barkley.
Hey, pick it up, defense.
They'll give it to him up the middle. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2 yard line. No gain on the play as we have reached the 2 minute warning. And we've hit the 2 minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Barkley, and he's going to bowl his way into the end zone for a Giants touchdown. Saquon Barkley, touchdown number 22 on the season. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, 2 already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Point after, right down the middle. And that makes it a 21-10 game. That one in the books as a 12-play drive. And it's capped off by a touchdown run from Saquon Barkley. To the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
They throw right away, and that's complete out on the right side. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. To throw again on second down. Prescott completes it to Miller. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Prescott. Oh, Prescott stripped. But I believe a Cowboy was there to get it. He was, and Dallas will maintain possession.
Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts, as he'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
To the air again, Prescott.
And break, the tight end's got it. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half.
On third down, it's Prescott. And this one hauled in by Rudolph.
And he gets this only to the 41. Not near enough for the first. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his fifth catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five. Now Prescott on fourth down. And he's got Kyle Rudolph. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. He was true on his first. This a tough one from 49 yards away. I don't think this will even, nope, it doesn't even get there. Well short, and this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something that feels somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go four verticals, because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get you caught up on what's going on around the NFL. We'll start up in the Steel City, Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, where it was the home team who were able to hold serve and get a victory in their stadium. James Conner, two touchdown runs to lead the way. Next, we head off to check out another game. And they were losers in that one to the visiting Arizona Cardinals. 21-10, the final score. And then one more to highlight, Monday Night Football. That'll be a good one between the Seattle Seahawks and the Oakland Raiders. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Second half ready to get rolling. The Giants with a lead, and they are set to receive this kick. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The New York set to take the field. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spend the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Barkley on first down, going to work his way forward, only for about a couple there. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw.
That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. He'll drop to throw. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Giants. A big play there. His second touchdown of the game, 17th on the year. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind. Because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
Extra point was hooking, but he does make it through. And the lead is up to 18 now. Scoring summary, three-play drive. And it was polished off by a Giants touchdown. Now after the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. And their halftime hole now even deeper. They need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
A nice start to the drive, picking up 12 yards there and a very quick first down. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Yes, indeed. That play there, that reminds me of some of the guys that I played with. They'll have that suddenness, able to get into the backfield almost about the time the ball snapped and make a play. How about that tackle for a loss?
Absolutely. He did a lot of that last week when he was named the NFC Defensive Player of the Week. One of the guys on the team was saying, yeah, we called him the disruptor, and that's carrying forward again.
Makes sense, doesn't it?
They'll wind up with seven on the dump off, but it'll set up third down. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Prescott to throw it, and Rudolph has it, the tight end. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. Seven catches for him now, and this last one, a first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Hey, here we go. Mike 54. Hey, come on out here. Come get some.
On first down, Elliott. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage.
Thank you.
Now on second and 13, Prescott, he's going to find Gallup here, complete. That catch good for five. It's third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Throwing, Prescott. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Well contained there defensively. The screen gets only a yard, and it's fourth. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. And New York set to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
They can't hang with us.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And this is caught at the 20. A big play there for the Giants. 64 yards. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. On the run, it's Barkley. And they're going to lose some on this play, being knocked back to the 18. What a difference a play makes. A huge step forward and now a small step back as he loses a yard or two.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments.
I got you. Here we go on second and 12. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. He'll look to throw. And he's going to go down. He sacked back into 24.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop and it can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
Fourth down, so Pat Shurmur trots out the field goal unit. This is a 40-yard attempt from the left hash. And his kick is indeed good. And that will extend their lead even further. So a good snap, good hold, and right down the middle.
Never in doubt. Just the way you used to hit them, partner.
You mean like kicking the ball?
Exactly.
Well, that was in high school.
Doesn't matter. I don't care what level. You hit them, they go through.
Following the field goal on is Riley Dixon to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. They trail here by 24 points. Got to get going soon, you'd have to think, as they come up first and 10. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8.
Yeah, let's get sack lunch.
Again, it's Elliott. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll run with Elliott. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action. But other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
And they'll get him down at about the 37, well short of the first. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be 4th down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll come on to kick for a 6th time tonight. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. Now, if you're a fan of punting, this game's for you. He's been out there quite a bit. That one may be his best yet.
Yeah, he certainly got his leg loose by now. It kind of reminds me of my college football coach, John Majors. He loved the punting game because he liked the positioning, the field position, and he loved to play defense.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own 5.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you go max protection, make it a 1-receiver route, and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur.
So 2nd and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on 1st down. Here's 2nd and 8. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
Well, let's go ahead and detail this situation here. 3rd and long coming up, back near your own goal line. I would be very hesitant about throwing the football in this situation.
Maybe just run up the middle?
Yeah, I think that might be the spot for them. You got to try.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. The 20. Touchdown, Giants. A big play there, 96 yards, and the Giants are able to add on to their lead. And I think it's safe to say we won't call many touchdown passes longer than that this year, partner.
No, I would agree with that totally. And right now, you're looking at an offensive coordinator. Conservative would not go next to his name. Risk taker, definitely, because he valued the opportunity to create a big play against what could have been disaster if they end up getting sacked or fumbling the ball in the shadow of their own goal line.
A try here for the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And it was finished off by a touchdown by the New York Giants. Now after the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point.
Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
So now they have to contend with 2nd and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Looking to throw, Prescott. Underneath, he's got Brate. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Khalil Mack in there to bring him down, and that is sack number 17 now on the season.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Man, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter, standing right on his own 5-yard line. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. This is fielded at the 27. Give him 11 yards that time on the return, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And New York set to take the field. The last time out, another touchdown. I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the 4th quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you because this was just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? Ooh. You and me, trying to get to the airport.
That's
the road
true.
To be fairly
that,
clear
that is
by the
one
time
positive.
We have to leave the booth.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. He's going to rifle one deep left side. It's caught at the 10. It's a big-time play there for the G-Man. 52 yards.
That's a big-time pitch and catch right there. And partner, I remember the days when quarterbacks would try this. They were holding their breath. But nowadays, they're counting on their receiver to be just a little bit better than the defensive back when it's one-on-one and the ball's in the air like that.
So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. They're going to look to throw. He'll find Metcalf. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Give him 9 there on the 1st down completion.
How about the timing on that one, where they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. This is Barkley. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
They'll go to the air here on third and two. And it's caught. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. From 3 yards out, as his guys continue to pour it on.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
Extra point attempt here still to come. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. So that drive, 4 plays. And it was polished off by a Giants touchdown. Now after the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys.
And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because 3 straight drives have ended with him punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, 22.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Here's Elliott. And an alley to run. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or creep or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. They'll run on first down. It's Elliott fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. 54 Mike. Check, check. 54. From the 35 on second down, Prescott. And Rudolph has it left side. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. In the secondary now for the Giants here on third. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Little pitch and catch here to Rudolph. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. That good for six as they keep this drive right on rolling. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. This is Elliott. He's able to work free for about six down to the 18.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
He's not going to get me.
They go to Elliott again. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive. Now Prescott. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. That good for six as they keep this drive right on rolling. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Here's Prescott. Oh, Elliott going to be hit. He coughs it up. Loose football. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, and that could have been trouble.
All I can say about this play is that someone's living right. I mean, he's trying to gain yardage, trying to get upfield. Ball comes free. What's that panic that we've talked about oftentimes that you feel when you lose the ball?
You can sense it.
Oh, you can sense it. And somehow he got to it and was able to recover it for his squad.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. From the shotgun again to Elliott. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4 yard line. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And wow, they've done that. That ball is caught. It's Gallup. Touchdown, Cowboys. Michael Gallup, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys are in for six. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Gold to add the extra point. And that'll cut the lead down to 28. So that drive, 12 plays in length, and it's capped off with a Cowboys touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And New York set to take the field. The outcome of this one, well, we know who's going to win it. It's just all window dressing at this point. Got me thinking, what's the biggest blowout that you've been a part of as a player, broadcaster?
Well, I'm not going to go to the player part, because when I think blowout...
Because you won every game as a player.
No. I think about being blown out. And no one wants to go back to those memories. But
you know, when I was calling college football, I saw a game that, you know, a team put 70. I actually saw it happen twice. A team put 70 on their opponent. And in the NFL in the 2017 season, I saw one of those changing of the guard games where a team that hadn't been very good before now was dominating and kicking around a team who had been ruling their division.
And that's when you earn your paycheck, bro. As the analyst, you got to fill that time.
You've got to know what's going on out there and how it all happened.
Well, obviously, that begs the question, what game was it?
That was Seattle hosting Los Angeles, the Rams.
Ah, yeah.
Their second meeting of the season, and the Rams turned it around from their first one and blew out the Seahawks.
First down, and that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Back to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the 5. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line.
Absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air. And that allows their punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Here we go. 4-8. Mike 54. Championships, baby.
Prescott on first down, and that's incomplete. Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. To throw is Prescott. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. That catch good for 5. It's third down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
The last play on the completion got him half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Khalil Mack in there to get him, and that is now sack number 18 on the season for him.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on to kick it away. And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick. Pulled in at the 24. Skirts by him at the 35. Now, nice job on the return there. 16 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
And New York set to take the field.
We've got a lopsided game here. I don't know, Charles, what does the handbook say that we discuss when we've got a game like this in the fourth quarter?
Hold on a second. Let me thumb to the proper page on that. Know what it says?
What?
Let's discuss how we got here. This is a dominant performance, where they took control of this game, how they've managed to keep control of this game, and then we go ahead and think about how we're going to leave here and get to the airport. In a lopsided blowout, the roads are usually open.
And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley with touchdown number 23 here on the year as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. Go ahead and give him the hat trick. He's been in the end zone now three times.
You toss your fedora first, okay? You go ahead and do that. But let's be honest about it. That third one, that's the most spectacular run he's had in the ballgame. It's almost as if he's been playing his own game of, can I top this? And each run has been more spectacular than the last.
Oh, I was just about to say he hadn't missed an extra point all season, but there it is. His first miss, no good. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This will be fielded at the 6. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Let's see what our player spotlight feature has in store with Dak Prescott. What can they do now, Charles, to make sure this highlight montage doesn't continue to show more pressure and pressure and pressure?
You feel like it always comes back to leverage, don't you? Who is going to win that battle of the offensive and defensive lines? Low man wins, we talk about that, but we think about it in a running game. But guess what? The same thing happens when you're trying to pass protect. Are you low? Are you balanced? Are you in a position where the pass rush won't bowl you over on their way back to the quarterback? They've got to reestablish that in order to try and keep their man upright.
Because they have been bowled over a lot so far in this one. Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. To throw on 2nd and 10. Prescott got his man there complete to Gallup. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up 3rd down. The last catch did get 3, but they're still left needing 7 yards on 3rd down. Now Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on here to punt it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. This will be fielded at the 17. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And out will come the offense as they take over. The offense takes the field, and we turn our attention to Saquon Barkley. I guess it kind of goes without saying at this point, but he's had a great game, as we like to say, a nose for the end zone, no doubt.
Continues to find it throughout this game, and I'm sure he's got a nice place to live. He might want to make an offer on the end zone for a second home, because that's what it's been like throughout this contest. He knows how to get there, and boy, he looks happy when he does.
He's already bought all the property in the end zone. That's the problem. He's going to sell to himself now. He'll get 15 and a Giants first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Keep it with Barkley on first down. He's got the first down here inside the 30. Shedding the tackler, and it gives him some room. A big hitter. That one goes for 40 yards.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
Try and run for it with Barkley. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the five down to the three.
Well, they made the play there, and I'll guarantee you, their coaches and the other players are screaming at them about their pride. Come on, guys. He's already gotten in three times. You can't give up a fourth one. And on that play, they were able to make the stop.
And you knew they were going to go to him to try to get that fourth.
And why wouldn't they? It's not just getting the fourth. He's the hot hand, so to speak, right? The hot feet in this situation. And he knows how to find the end zone. That time, he just didn't get there.
On second down now, Laird. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
So they're back at the 7 now for third and goal.
Hey, I'm coming.
Catch made by Slayton. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Darius Slayton, his fourth touchdown on the year as his guys continue to pour it on.
And now we've hit that stage of the game, partner, where one of our predecessors, one of the great commentators of all time, he's a sing in this situation when this game appeared to be over.
I know the fat lady's been singing for some time.
No, not her at all. This
but
one of
she's
our guys.
Singing too.
Oh, she's singing.
She's on like the fifth tune.
Yeah, she left scales way behind. But he's singing something about turning out the lights. The party was over.
The extra point splits the uprights, and the lead will swell by one more. Now after the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And some time here to focus on Kyle Rudolph as he heads back out there. And this is how the game has trended for him numbers-wise. He's really picked it up. And I got to be honest, I don't know schematically. This is where I need you. What does the defense need to do to get back to that start that they had on him?
You've got to harass him early in his route. Right off the line of scrimmage, someone needs to be there. So it's not what we call a free release where he just gets into the route so easily. Because once he builds up momentum and speed, forget it, you're done. Knock him off of that, chip away at his timing, and then make sure you have a second person there in the vicinity as well. Too big and too strong usually for one person to handle.
Taken down here. Great coverage downfield. The sack coming from big Dalvin Tomlinson. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Yeah, and that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Prescott from the gun. And this one hauled in by Rudolph. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah,
like
hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Taking it about the 16. A terrific return there. 27 yards all told. The New York set to take the field. And Charles, in a very one-sided affair, I think we've reached the point in the broadcast for you and I, we may have some filling to do, right?
Yeah, I think you're right about that because we got to try and keep people around. We don't want them to change the channel. Stay with us in this game. Is that Ben Ramsar? Are you hearing from Ben on the headset here telling us
stretch
this thing out a little bit?
Get some talking points. Dig them all out.
That's what you get. A big-time producer, keep them here.
Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. First down for the Giants as they pick up 12.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Let's go, baby.
Again, it's Barkley. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
The Giants on third down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This will be third and 6. Action fake. They'll look to throw. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Here's Riley Dixon now, as he's on to punt for New York.
Let's go, baby! Let's go!
And out now come the Cowboys. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Dak dropping this one off for Zeke. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and it'll be second down. From the 22, here's second and 8. Prescott down. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Hey, check, check.
To the air again, Prescott. That one complete to Elliott. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Throwing, Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Khalil Mack in there for the sack, and he's closing in on the all-time record. That's number 19 on the year.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Prescott, that's Elliott, complete. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and they're going to be staring at a third and long here. Third and long for Prescott. He's going to let it fly. And unable to connect, incomplete. I give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on to kick it away. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point.
Push him back.
That one looks like he'll throw here. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. They're still throwing the football here. Now, obviously, the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving. Keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. It's a gain of 11 and a Giant first down.
I know we're in the era of wide open football, a lot of spread formations, more space, but there's still a spot for power football. And we just saw some of it right there. How about that run?
Yeah, breaking the tackle. And, you know, late in this game, he wants the football in his hands. He's had a good day. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
We ain't beginning to tear you up. Don't get nervous.
They'll run it again with Barkley. And he'll work this one up to about the 38.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking.
they think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Giants, they climb back to 500 now at 3 up and 3 down. And they'll get another home date next week as the Eagles will come to town. Meanwhile, for the Cowboys, they taste defeat for the first time this season as they drop to 5-1. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.